you put it in perspective, John, from 2012, where were we in terms of calling states?
Well, in 2012, by now, the battleground states, although Michigan wasn't as much of a battleground as it is right now, was called by now, as was Pennsylvania.
Bottom line, to follow on your line, if you're a Clinton supporter, you're popping an anti-anxiety pill right now. Charlie Rose is over with the panel. Charlie?
Thank you, Norm. We're talking. Remember, the first thing we said at 7 o'clock, it's a tight race. Jamel?
I want to talk a bit more about that cultural resistance. Remember, Trump ran his campaign. He began his campaign attacking Hispanic immigrants and various other racial and ethnic minorities. I think some of this cultural anger we should correctly identify as being racial animus, and that it's significant that Trump has closed so much of a gap and done so well with white voters across the country.
Racial because they believe as they gain in terms of voter strength and economic strength, that they were losing.
Correct. Well, I mean, Donald Trump has run, for Republican especially, a very negative campaign. Not just so much negative as far as attacking his opponent, but also negative, very pessimistic. It's like America is really suffering. Make America great again. It's backward looking.
News is making a new projection for the state of Ohio. And there is the state of Ohio. CBS News is projecting that once all the votes are counted, Donald Trump will win Ohio. Now, this keeps his hopes alive. Ohio was a very important state for him to win.
But it's also a state where Hillary Clinton pulled out all the stops in terms of star power that she brought to Ohio. And it shows you that celebrity endorsement don't necessarily mean victory on election day.
Is the women's vote influencing this election?
Well, look, we may be in the middle of witnessing an epic upset here. If his attitude towards and language towards women, minorities, etc., had not been so alienating.
Is it fair to say the three of you, when you came here this evening, did not believe that Donald Trump might win this election, and now you all three think it's possible?
Well, he had a very narrow path at the beginning of the evening, but it seems like that path is not as narrow as it was. I mean, I think, speaking of the room, I think all of us feel that that changed within the last hour.
Yeah, past hour and a half, we started to see, wait a second, expectations in the polls are not being borne out by the numbers we're seeing on the screen right now.
One of the interesting things, Nora, is that since the nomination of the two candidates, Donald Trump has never led in the CBS News poll, never been ahead since he and Hillary Clinton were nominated, and yet tonight he's keeping up quite well.
Oh, to be a fly on the wall at Trump Tower or at the hotel where Hillary Clinton and her team are tonight to find out what they are thinking at this hour. For those that are calling their therapists right now, the night is still young. Stay tuned, because there are still a number of white states still on the map that we have not
found. From the point that he was nominated to this night, he was never in the lead against Hillary Clinton, and now he is running neck and neck with her. The electoral college count right now is Hillary Clinton 197. Donald Trump won.
But everything about him, Scott, has been so unconventional. When we first started with 17 candidates, everybody kept saying it's in the end it will be Hillary Clinton and Jeb Bush standing at the end. Everything about him has been unconventional from the very beginning. He kept winning and winning and winning, and here we are tonight.
Breaking news, CBS News now estimates that Donald Trump will be the winner in Florida. This was key to the Trump campaign. He virtually could not win the presidency without Florida. He has now racked up Florida, North Carolina, and Ohio by our estimates. This is the Clinton campaign, the watch party of the Clinton campaign. Clearly a great deal of concern there at this point in the evening. Charlie Rose is with our political panel. Charlie.
The question is, what's going on? What's happening? And how will it end up?
This is a populist wave. We're not sure if the wave is high enough to elect Donald Trump yet, but it's a real wave. It involves a reaction against globalism and multiculturalism and a culture that people think is condescending.
It's a movement that's very frustrated, disappointed with both the Republican and the Democratic Party. In many ways, the ways they see them is very similar. and they wanted an outsider to come in and break up Washington.
Nora is just watching these data come in.
That's
Nora?
Right. CBS News is projecting that in the state of Iowa, Donald Trump has won.
You have been saying that this is also a reflection of a lack of belief in institutions and now including polls.
It confirms the suspicions of a lot of conservatives in America about elite opinion being wrong, about polling being wrong. Donald Trump's appeal was an idea that there is a conspiracy of the establishment, and this looks like it because it was so systematically wrong
this
in these areas.
Tonight is confirmation.
Yeah, I think they will take it as confirmation that elite culture was against them.
Donald Trump is now, by my count, 42 votes away from having the 270 he needs.
And you can see that on the faces of the people at the Clinton election night watch party here in New York City. Nancy Cordes is there. Nancy, tell us about the mood.
Now, the Clinton campaign itself was very chatty earlier in the night. They thought quite quiet, but I did manage to get through to a Clinton aide a short time ago who says that they do believe that they will pull out a victory in Michigan and in Wisconsin at the end. But the fact that these two races are close at all, once again, is a real shock.
Major Garrett is at Trump headquarters tonight. Major?
So Scott and Nora, over the last 3 or 4 days, Donald Trump has worked at breakneck pace, 5-6 rallies a day, going to all these battleground states, drawing enormous crowds, crowds that sometimes would wait 6 or 7 hours for him to show up. Anyone who stands in line for 7 hours to not see a concert and not be fed is going to show up at a polling booth and cast a ballot.
Word got said Canada's immigration site has crashed because there's been so many inquiries about moving to Canada.
Tell me what you think is happening here, because it is within 26 votes of Donald Trump having 270.
All right. It's epic. It is surprising. It is, to my mind, what I think I'm seeing is a kind of uprising, a kind of revolt, a kind of pushback against the elites, the establishments of both parties. There is a sense of there's protected people in America and unprotected people, and the unprotected just push back in a way that strikes me as deeply historic.
The extent to which Donald Trump has won, running a campaign of racism and bigotry, turning out millions of white Americans for that campaign, suggests that we are living through a kind of second redemption, a kind of pushback against the advancement of African Americans, of Hispanics, of women, of Muslim Americans. And I don't know how long we live with that backlash.
Because Pennsylvania is the biggest prize still left on the table with 20 electoral votes. And with just about 84% of the vote in, or is it more there? I can't see that far. Based on my computer, 90% of the vote in, it is neck and neck. According to what I'm seeing, we're talking about a vote difference of just about 10,000.
And she had been ahead in the numbers. So this is, if you're a Clinton person watching this, the numbers are going in the wrong direction.
There's one thing said about Donald Trump repeatedly in the 16 months I've been on the road. It's that this person, whatever his flaws, cannot be bought.
There are some more votes coming in, and they are the votes of Wall Street. Have a look at the Dow futures tonight. They are down at this moment 840 points. That's almost 4.6%. Those are the Dow futures as they stand right now.
Yogi Berra said, it's not over till it's over, and we can't repeat that enough. But Donald Trump is leading in enough states to get him to 270. So I raised this question. What if Donald Trump becomes president?
Well, people concerned about that need to remember the president doesn't get to do everything he wants, although he has tremendous power on the international stage. And this is someone who the Russians wanted to have elected, may have actually helped to get elected, and someone that our alliance, people in our alliance structure are very afraid about what's going to happen.
So I want Michael to be right about the resilience and strength of the other branches of government, but I'm really worried that he's not. Why would we think that Republicans in Congress who were not willing to denounce and reject Donald Trump when he said outrageous things about Gold Star families and Mexican rapists and everything else, would be willing to reject him when he is inhabiting, if he is, the most powerful position in the land.
Been at the Clinton watch party, and Nancy, what is the mood like there?
Nora, it's like all the air has been sucked out of the room and everyone is holding their breath. It's almost entirely silent here.
Tell me, what do you think?
This is inconceivable 5-6 hours ago. First, all exit polling should be banned. The fact is the numbers were wrong all the way across the table on state after state after state. The 5 p.m., the second wave got it wrong.
Tens of millions of Americans tonight who are experiencing this evening not only as a political event and a historical event, but as a spiritual event. They feel grateful. They feel they are rebuking a decayed establishment that has richly earned a rebuke in 25 different ways. Spoke to a friend of mine, a major Trump supporter, this evening. He told me, I just spoke to him, he said, I said, how did you react when you realized this was going to happen? He's a tough, hard-boiled guy, and he said, it was 9 p.m., and I burst into tears. He said, this is really going to be something. He said, but it's the right thing, we are certain.
His people came out in the right places, in the right numbers, and brought an extraordinary upset, one of the largest in American history. And I think that's all true.
Largest political upset in American history if he goes on to win.
Yeah, I think that's certainly
in our lifetime. Certainly.
Yeah. This is also a validation of a certain kind of politics, more cruel, more ruthless, more personal than any I've seen in my lifetime.
And an array of surrogates. The president and the first lady, yeah. The former president, Elizabeth Warren, Bernie Sanders.
Joe Biden.
All Joe Biden. Yeah. All out for her. Donald Trump had nobody but himself.
You know what?
For some people, this is a very scary moment. There are a lot of people, this feels like a thunderclap.
The thing to keep in mind, though, is that while we may look at this as being a moment of chaos and around the world and certainly in the markets, I think that they are looking at it that way. From the perspective of the people who voted for Trump, this was an act of democracy.
Nancy Cordes is in the rapidly emptying Jacob Javits Center for us tonight. Nancy?
Well, Scott, it looks like people are heeding John Podesta's advice and filing out. You can see some people are crying. Some people just look kind of stunned. And I think the Clinton campaign itself is trying to figure out what to do next. Does Hillary Clinton stay here in Manhattan or go home to Chappaqua? If they say something in the morning, what do they say?
Donald Trump now has slender numerical majorities in all 5 of the swing states that are outstanding. He only needs to win, depending on the state, 2 or 3 of these. Hillary Clinton would have to win nearly all of them.
I must say the political operators in Washington, even the Republican establishment, thought that Donald Trump was not going to win. So he knew something that they didn't.
These are live pictures of the Trump watch party. Donald Trump is there, we are told, and we understand that he will be taking the stage at any moment. And we will first go to Major Garrett, who is there at campaign headquarters. Major?
Well, there's a roar of approval here you can hear behind me. We have been told, I believe, I can confirm that Hillary Clinton has called Donald Trump to concede. We expect Donald Trump to come out here any moment and announce that to his throng of supporters at the Hilton Hotel in Midtown Manhattan, and that this moment, long sought by Donald Trump, long disbelieved by some in the Republican Party, everyone in the Democratic Party, and a good number of the American people still unsure about Donald Trump, apparently has come. And the atmosphere, as you can imagine here, is elated.
We have this odd moment in America where we're passing the baton from the nation's first black president to a candidate who was endorsed by the KKK and did not denounce that.
Exactly.
I think we have witnessed tonight something epical and grave. I think it is the beginning of a new era whose shape and form and content are not known to us and are not clear, whose personnel and exact direction.
One is, this is really a historic achievement in America. I mean, it's historic. Nothing like this has ever happened before. And secondly, you have to give him credit. I mean, he has achieved something that no one from the beginning ever believed he could do.